Looks like I've been here all day. I hope that.
Total revamping of the criminal justice, you know, Reform Act and how that they raised the threshold on felonies from $500 to $1,500 and a few other things that were being misdemeanors, you know, felonies in the past. Well, yeah, once.
So many are, yeah.
You know, they've been charged with felony and it's addicted. It's the state's responsibility. They can pick them up and put them in state prison. Well, now it's all bad misdemeanor.
But that's all.
Well, where do people spend, where do they serve their time on misdemeanor charges? They're gonna serve their time instead of going into the state system, they're gonna wind up serving whatever couple of months they've gotta serve. They save their self-money, but they're gonna pass the cost on to us.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It sounded good for them, but you're right, with a good little misdemeanor.
They're gonna wind up serving their time for 6 months or whatever it can in jail now.
In this new jail.
It's our cause and our problem.
I make room with it, just to come back down.
And then they went and changed all that synthetic marijuana laws, you know.
And we're trying to make it tougher.
How are you?
Good, thank you. Law firm will represent some of these mergers. Everything they had on the shelves.
Yeah, and I already had the drafts, earlier drafts. Thank you.
That, once again, is in compliance. They knew what was going to be in that legislation. Their lobbyists knew, everybody knew, and so as soon as they signed the deal, and we're monitoring all of them, well, they wiped everything off the shelf.
It's hard to tell in the field exactly what the substance is.
There's no way to tell what the substance is. Because it is not marketed as a product for human consumption. It is marketed as incense, things like that. Well, there's absolutely no FDA requirement that there be any type of ingredient listing. It's not marketed for it. They've got it stamped on the package. Clearly, it says not for human consumption.
Where do you want it? They said we've got two commissioners that's got half seats. Say right here.
What was it?
Did you get that?
You can get off.
Judge Bedwick went out, he's in trial. If there is going to be any kind of vote regarding architecture, he does want to be here, and I'll email him. Why we can't go out for the architect right now, because we know we need to have an architect. It's not like that's changing, that's not
setting how we want to do our delivery method, because I know you said you wanted the program manager to be involved in doing that, so that would not change your plan whatsoever. It would just speed up the process.
Discussion.
So basically, you just want to put out the RFP, just see who's interested, ask for bids.
We'd ask for a qualification. We'd do a qualification based for architects, that's correct, for building the courthouse and jail.
Now, the presumption is that by the time the RFPs close, that we should have the project manager on board by then. Is that correct?
We probably would. You know, it's always a timing thing.
It will obviously be very close.
It'd be very close.
Well, we're obviously looking at that to be one of the first things that they would be involved in, would be going through the RFPs on the architecture.
I would suggest that they would help us with reviewing them. They would be part of that selection committee. Yes.
How long a process do you think it would take to get the, how long to get the architects online on board?
For the architects? It would be out on the street again in probably 4 to 6 weeks. So after that, it'd be in probably another 4 weeks. So it would take some time. So this way, like I said, with the program manager, that RFP closes on the 24th of May. I've already set up a kickoff meeting for the selection committee on that. So we'll be moving quite quickly.
No, and I think but once again, the recommendation for the RFP will then have to go before the full board.
Well,
I presume.
Yeah, well, we took, if you may recall that we took, out of this board, we took the RFP for the program manager to the board, requesting permission to go out to RFP. Donna, I would assume we would do the same thing in this case.
I believe that's how it's been set up, okay. How the boards have been set up. So then we go to the next work session?
Yes.
Is that May 8th?
And that's where I was leading up to, since we had what? One will be able to communicate before the board.
Yeah.
If we do it on May 8th, and if we did it as time sensitive, I hopefully have it prepared so we can go out after it.
Okay.
Need a motion or do we just?
I think we should. We probably need to do that. Do I hear a motion to ask Donna to prepare the paperwork to go before the Board of Commissioners requesting?
I have the rest to vote on this.
Oh, he does want, okay.
Yes.
Live, okay.
Let me send him.
Okay.
If you want to do it, he has to stop the trial.
I'm not trying to influence his decision, but we're obviously not voting on any designs.
Anything regarding architecture, he said he wanted to vote on.
Yeah, we can go back to that. We'll go to item number two. And before I forget, please do me a favor before you leave today. Get with Kathy and sign the official minutes from the previous meeting, if you will, before you leave. I would really appreciate that. Item two, review funding options. At the last meeting, this committee asked Dave Ruin to prepare some documents with respect to funding options. At that meeting, we also defined, if you will, the what a local bank is. And Dave has prepared some documentation, has done a lot of research, and I appreciate that, Dave, and prepared to present that to you today.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. If I can draw the team's attention to a two-page document I handed out at the beginning of the meeting. It's got three hole punches in it. And particularly to show how we've got to where we are right now for the front page, if you flip to the back page, I'll give you a little bit some detail. Actually, this was my original worksheet. To follow up on the project team's interest expressed last time in perhaps pursuing a bank loan for any needed financing for this project, went ahead and pursued those channels. We first got a list of banks that have a branch in the county, have a banking presence. There was 20 such banks, which when I started off, you'd ask me how many there were. I didn't think there were that many. There are 20 banks that have a presence in this county. Of those, 10 would meet the definition that the project team submitted as a Georgia bank. Of those 10 I've listed on this worksheet here that I attached in a list, and I can walk you through just this a little bit briefly. Two of the 10 would be considered purely Forsyth County banks, if you will. We'll see those at the bottom in the syndicate. What I did is I researched each of these banks to see who, first of all, would be large enough to handle a loan of $30 or $40 million for the county and be able to. And that, from that, I eliminated about three of them that are fairly small, only have one or two branches. Their assets are well under $1 billion. And then I proceeded to contact the remaining ones, and the local ones actually, for the team's encouragement here, actually came in and talked with us, which was fine. Where I ended up is with these banks and institutions that would be interested at this point in providing this kind of funding to the county. Just starting from the top of the list of those that are shaded, they have the Bank of North Georgia, who was a part of Synovus, Community and Southern Bank, Hamilton State Bank, and SunTrust Bank. At the bottom, there's a group of three, including the two Forsyth County local banks, that have gone in together to form what's called a syndicate in banking, when a group of banks join together to provide funding for a large project. And that is in combination United Community Bank, Citizens Bank of Forsyth County, and Community Business Bank. So when you group those together right now, of a list of Georgia banks, what we define as Georgia banks, we would have five that are interested. And actually, what we see in the front page, Hamilton State Bank said they would like to participate, but they are only capitalized to handle up to $20 million. So they're probably marginal being included. And you can see their assets are $1.4 billion. So it looks like it takes a bank with above $2 billion in assets to participate in a loan on their own of this size. With that group, I had contacted the various ones, found out who was interested. All I asked them to do at this point was to bring forth ideas as far as how would they structure this kind of funding. I gave them some parameters of up to $40 million, about a four-year loan where we could draw when we needed it, pay it back as soon as we wanted to, and so on. And so I just wanted to see ideas from the banks, not a formal quote or commitment, but how would you structure, what would you recommend to the county? And so we already had some submit those ideas, others are still working on them. And I said at such a time that the commission would decide to go this route, and we had a dollar amount, and we're ready to go. If this is the way we go, we would then contact if it's at least four or five, and ask for a more formal proposal that the commission could decide who to go with. So this is pretty much the lay of the land, if you will, of Georgia banks that could participate. Now let me, before I forget, we'll get back to the first page. One thing I had to change after I first asked them to do it on a four-year basis, and that is we found in reviewing the referendum approved by the voters for general obligation debt that there is a debt service schedule, if you will, and over the 6 years, there's a maximum amount of principal to be paid back in any 1 year. Check with the county attorney to see that indeed looks like what it says, and he confirmed that we are bound by that. So in other words, if we were to borrow $40 million and wanted to pay it all back in 2 years, as the collections provide that, that limitation does not allow us to do that. So we had to alter this scenario a little bit. It roughly runs about $14 to $15 million a year we're allowed to repay across the sales tax collection. So that means what that did was it pushed it out from a four-year loan to a five-year loan. We could pay it all back within 5 years from the beginning of the loan. And that, of course, added a little bit more interest cost to this.
That's if you borrow that much, $14 or $15 million.
If you borrow that much. So, yeah, if the loan is under $30 million, I think we could do it within 4 years. I've reflected that in some of these comments. Here's my registered comment. Here's the banks in second. With that, unless you have any questions about the banks, we can move to the first page, and I'll quickly give you what I found in putting certain assumptions on here as far as interest rates of where I see the market right now. We just did a bond issue this past month for just under $30 million. So I know what the actual bond rates we're able to get with our rating, and I've got those, how they look. Looking at one of the indexes that banks often peg their variable rates to, which is the LIBOR 30-day rate, looking where that is, where the market is right now, interest rates. Briefly, here's what I found. I can hit some of the highlights, but, and this is true of these types of financing vehicles, bonds for a local government will normally give you a lower interest rate than a bank loan. However, you need to combine that with the issuance costs, which are higher. The bank loan, and I'll show you some details that should bear this out, will usually be at a higher interest rate, but the costs are much lower. In general, when you match the two up, they can be very comparable, and that's what I found out here with these terms. We're sort of right in the middle. It's a bit of a toss-up if right now with these terms, which way should we go? in general, as the dollar amount gets higher, the term gets longer, a little bit of the official economies of scale almost, you lean more toward bonds. If the dollar amount gets lesser, and this is going to be true here, and the term gets shorter, such as 4 or 5 years, the bank loan looks to be more favorable. And that's pretty much what I found by laying out these numbers. I'll give briefly the assumptions I had. Under the bank loan option, paying it back as fast as we're allowed to under the referendum through 2015, 16, 17, borrowing up to $40 million. I used an average interest rate of 2.6%, which includes mostly a fixed rate component to it to be comparable to the bond option I have here. The interest cost would come out on that based on drawing it as we need it, paying it back within those 3 years to about $2.5 million. And then there'd be some loan fees and legal fees, which combined, depending on the legal fees, could reach easily $50,000. I think there'll be less than $100,000 in total, depending on how the bank gives a proposal. And then I relisted here the interested banks. The bond funding option right now, based on the bond issue we just did, in these terms, probably give us an average yield of about 1.3%. So you can see the difference, about half the interest rate under these assumptions. And that would give us an interest cost, having to borrow it all at once, having to pay it back in a certain schedule, just over $2 million, with bond issuance cost as much as $500,000. So in my summary or brief conclusions at the bottom, comparing these two, the bank loan under these terms would be about $80,000 higher in cost, about 3.2% higher than the bond cost, comparing about $2.6 million versus $2,520,000. That is relatively cut. I mean, $80,000 is a significant amount of money, but all it changes a little bit of a shift in the market and the amounts you borrow, and it can change the decisions of which one you go with based on cost. Give you an idea of that, for each million less we borrow, a little bit of a sensitivity analysis, the bank loan comes down about $64,000 in interest costs for every million less we borrow. The bond would come down about $51,000 on these terms. So it comes down that way. With each shift of 0.1%, the bank loan would change about $100,000 in interest, and the bond almost close to $200,000 in interest. So that shows you, if these terms shift a little bit, the amount you borrow, the timing, the interest rates, how the decision could change. Where I came down to after all that, if you know, the team asked, well, what would your recommendation be at this point? And it's really one of those answers that it starts with, it depends. And that's how a lot of things come out when it comes to finances. But at the very bottom of the page, I just said simply, number one, if we need $40 million with a fixed cost of a bond issue, what's known with the low interest rates we have right now, which ran from the actual yield from 2015 through 2019 on this last bond issue, ran from 0.74% up to 1.81%, so very low interest rates. If we were able to lock those in the bond issue, we needed $40 million, we have to repay back over several years. I would lean toward the issuing bonds. But number two is the amount becomes less than $40 million, and right now it sounds like with our current time frame we probably are not going to need cash in July, you know, for architecture, maybe August, maybe September. If the amount needed comes down with the flexible terms of a bank loan, I think that becomes more favorable. And I came up with, this was my breakpoint, I think if we get to $30 million or less, I think the answer is going to be pretty clear to go with the bank financing. If it's between $30 up to $40 million, bond is still going to be in play. And especially because once you get under $30 million, we can repay it within 2 years. We can do a 4-year loan with the bank. That's part of the reason. So hopefully that wasn't too much dated, which can be confusing at times, but I wanted to lay this out on the page before the team to sort of show you where we are and to give you a report as requested by the team in our last meeting. With that, I'll take any questions.
Have you taken in consideration that we still have to keep engineering funded somewhat during this process, and how much you need to borrow?
Well, initially, if we were going to pay it all up, this all up front, there would be nothing available for other projects or engineering into the fourth year. Sort of in effect, I'm not sure if the writers of the law that said you have to spread out the repayment, if that was intended or not, but by having to repay it over 3 years, that would make funding available for other projects earlier. And the other way the commission could have more funding for the projects earlier if that was desired would be to borrow more. I mean, we're not limited to $40 million. We could borrow up to $89 million as authorized for this project. What that would do is make more of the jail and courthouse come under the borrowed funds and more of the other dollars available for other projects, depending on the repayment schedule, if you push it out to 2019.
Chair, I have a question. Mr. Bruin. We really don't know at this point how much money we're going to need.
Correct. That's the uncertainty right now.
25, may not be 25 million, maybe 40, as you said. We don't know. On the other hand, I was looking at your funding option with the interest rate. You have a 1.3, and of course you talked about the interest rate of the bank loan, maybe at 2.6. You don't know that's going to be 2.6.
Don't know.
Anything that would come in under that would be a bonus based on the county doing business right. with local banks.
Right, gives you this cost
okay.
rate.
In your funding option, you got your interest rate, your interest cost, and your bond insurance cost. I didn't see a fee down there for bonding attorney, and usually when you do bonds, don't you have to have a bonding fee for attorneys?
Right, that's all included in the bond issuance cost. That includes all the attorneys, underwriters, attorneys, bond counsel, the rating agencies, issuing the official statement, all those costs are included there, which equals about 1.25% of the bond issue.
But that...
That's included.
All of these numbers are subjective. You really don't know that that's what it's going to cost.
They could end up different from what's here. That's why I give you my assumptions, so you know what they're based on. Change the assumptions and the answer changes.
So basically, if we stay around or under 30 million, the bank is our best option, so we can pay it off.
At this distance, it looks like it. With the market rates the way they are now.
Mr. Amos, have you had an opportunity to talk with engineering at all to see what their needs might be during this process? I hate to shut them down completely for 3 years. I'm on their project lists.
Well,
half this lost time.
We don't know what we're going to collect. We may collect more than 14, 15 million a year. Our collection,
collections are strong. Dave, using those numbers as assumptions, there would be additional funds available for other projects.
Right. I updated all of these assumptions based on our completed last year's collections. Now, the first 2 months this year, we're up 8.5% over the first 2 months last year. I don't know if that'll continue, but we could be up 4% on the year. And to the extent we exceed what I projected the collections to be, the $203 million, other funds will be available.
Yeah, so we have funds. But for other projects.
Interrupt just for a minute. Do we need to go back to item number one and handle that so the judge can get back to
okay. Yes, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you for being here. Item one was consider preparation of architectural services, RFP. Judge, there was discussion about that. And we got to the point where there was a motion to proceed with RFP for architectural services. That's where we were on that item. Is that correct? Was there a motion for that? Okay. Is there a motion to proceed with the RFP for architectural services?
So moved. Second.
First, motion and a second. Those in favor of moving forward, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, signify by the same. There being none, that motion passes.
What about the selection committee? Who will be on the selection committee?
You want to help with that number?
You could change it, or it could be the same people that you currently have on your program management selection committee. But the only inclusion would be the program manager would probably be involved as well.
Okay, who's on the selection committee currently?
Currently, it is Don Childress. I have it right here. Captain Chuck Smith, Steve Rhodes, who's the capital project manager, Tim Merritt, Don Childress, Scott Morgan from the City of Cumming, and I'm a non-voting member.
Okay. That's good with me, as long as I can voice my opinion, as long as I've got a voice here with Ms. Childress on that, because that's critically important to me, is the architectural firm that is hired to get the bid on this project. Critically important.
Donna, do you need a motion or perhaps without exception to move forward with, or at least establish that that's the evaluation team for
well.
That?
That would be fine.
Yeah. Without exception, or do you want to make a motion?
I think without
use
exception.
Use the same team?
The same thing.
Okay. Without exception? Okay. Yeah. All right.
So, Mr. Chairman, the only other item on the agenda is review funding options. Is that correct?
That's correct.
that I'm disqualified, but I think I mentioned last time that serving on the board of the Citizens Bank for Forsyth County, I am absolutely disqualified from that discussion. Plus, I've got a jury waiting to get started back, so I will take my leave. Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, we're back to item two, review of funding options. Additional discussion?
Yeah, one more thing. Sure. Good question the mayor brought up about interest rates and bank loans. I'll give you a little bit of what I've seen, a little bit market-wise, a little bit of what the banks have talked about. Remember, a fixed rate is going to be, for 5 years, it's going to be at least at 2.6%. It could be higher. We're going to go right in and say, give us a quote for a five-year loan. Variable rates are lower, and they're probably going to be in the range of 2.1%, 2.2%, somewhere around there, from what we're starting to see from some of the banks. Think about variable rates, and they may stay flat for right now in the market. It's at least 2 years, but you know, world economy, I'm not going to make any bets in interest rates myself. The fact they're variable is just there's a component of risk to that and cost, especially since the repayment's going to be a little bit more back-end loaded. So that gives you a little bit more of an idea of interest rate cost with banks. Variable rate right now, you can probably get low twos, 2.1%. Fixed rate for 5 years is going to be above, I think 2.6 is probably pretty close to where I think the market is now. The only other thing to consider there, and we could also do a variable rate bond, and that would be much lower than 1.3% now.
Too much risk.
Change.
Too much risk.
And too much risk. And the thing where I can see that risk, others are sensitive to it. In our discussion with the rating agencies, particularly S&P, they were really drilling us on questions about, we only have one variable rate bond out there right now. And when they were doing our rating, their double A-plus rating, I think we might get AAA, that made them very nervous to have a variable rate issue out there, and under what scenarios could it be called in and so on. So, you know, variable rate is tempting because it's so low, but I think fixed rates are likewise as low as you're ever going to see them pretty much right now. So that just add a little bit to the discussion of interest rates and risk.
Dave, one question. When do you think we'll know if we need a 30 or 40 or 50 million? I mean, what's our time frame on this?
I think as we have an idea when we'll have an architect on board, because then they're going to start doing work and we're going to start needing cash. That will give us a much better idea of maybe which month toward the end of this year. I think it's going to be before January 1, we'll probably need some funding, but I'm not sure how close to July at this point. But, and there's one other thing involved here with the county, Commissioner Levent was pointing out, that may affect the amount, is what about other projects and road projects and, you know, engineering and so on. So the commission maybe have some concern there, and that could affect the amount we borrow for the jail and courthouse, but it affects how much of the other dollars are available for other projects. So
they do 1, 2, 3, 4 streets per neighborhood around the whole county every year just to try to keep up with the road improvements. And I hate to see them shut those down for 3 or 4 years and then us try to catch up. It'd be very hard on them.
On the bond, I favor the banks, but this is the reason. If you do a bond and say you got to have $40 million, you do a bond for $40 million. You start paying interest on it.
Right.
On the banks, you pay interest on what you borrow right at that particular day. If you borrow $1 million, if you have a pay request, I think you can expedite the project a lot faster by doing it through local banks and have one bank who is going to work with all the local banks, and they got their pool of ever how much money the board votes they need down the road, whether it's 30 million, 40 million, or whatever, which I think it'll be somewhat less probably because another year the SPLOST 7 revenue is going to be coming in, and as Chairman alluded to, you've got maybe 8% over what it was last year right now, and you say it could be as much as 4% throughout the year. So if we're going to be taking in the revenue, we don't want to be, I think logic would be that you'd use that revenue to pay down the loan, and you won't be penalized due to the fact this local banks rather than a bonding company. So that's my theory.
I would agree with you, Mayor. In addition to that, you want to borrow it right away, so you'll save interest on it.
But, and I did take that timing into consideration of this $2 million versus $2.5 million interest. I did take into consideration the bond issue all at once and drawing the banks down. So even though this bank rate of 2.6% is twice 1.3%, you notice the cost is not twice as much because I've calculated in only paying interest on when we draw the money.
What kind of time frame do we need to deal with banks or bond company? We need to start 2 months before we need the money, or 30 days, or that could be critical.
I mean, the bank is ready, once they do their credit checks, and some of them, the banks have already been working on this, and they're virtually ready to go themselves. The time constraint there is getting all the legal documents in place. The lawyers still have to work on the documents, the bank's lawyers, our counsel, it'll be just as binding as a bond issue. I mean, it'll be that secure for the banks as a bond issue, as a bondholder would be. So, as fast as the attorneys can get all the paperwork, so I'm thinking probably within 30 days would be my guess on that.
If we use the $40 million, if we bond it, if we went for a bond for $40 million, and then at the end of the day, we only use $30 million, that additional $10 million could not be redirected to other projects because of the, as I understand, the wording in the referendum, it's still going to be locked in correct. To this project.
Correct.
Whether we needed it or not.
Well, as money comes in, you don't have to throw it in the jail courthouse and you can use that for the other projects.
That is another point. You're right. I mean, that with that cushion, then other monies from the SPLOST could be redirected to the other projects.
Mm-hmm. And all of our other departments will be able to keep up with their duties and not get so far behind.
Right.
We borrow $40 million. These projects, two projects, are $100 million. So they will be first dollar. We will, I think, whatever we borrow is going to be considered going to the jail courthouse.
Sure.
It just leaves some of the sales tax collections available then.
And then on the other hand, these bond funding options and the bank loan options are really moving targets, because under the bond funding, you've got options there that don't compare with banks, because the banks may be paid back quicker than you'll pay the bonds back.
Well, only up to $14 to $15 million per year, because a referendum restricts our ability to do that.
But say for instance you wanted to do that in the bank, you could do that where you're not legally bound to do that with bonds.
Right. You have more flexibility with the bank loan as to how much you borrow and when you pay it back. Right. Bond is a fixed issue, although you can have call provision in a bond, which means you can pay it back earlier. But if you have a call provision,
a
that pushes the interest rate up.
It's a penalty.
There's a premium for that.
Is this some decision we need to make today?
I think I was just reporting based on the committee's interest.
Yeah, I don't really think that we can make a decision unless
right.
We have a more
uncertainty.
Right. There's still this uncertainty about the exact amount of money we're talking about here, but understanding what our options are.
What I convey to the banks is we're trying to be in a position where where we want to go. The board commission wants to do that. We're ready to go with them.
So sure.
And then we have selected a group that's interested.
Well, to save you time and energy, does this board need to vote whether we want to go bonds or banks? I don't know if the board could go ahead and decide to say.
I wouldn't recommend that at this point, since the cost could vary on which vehicle you use, depending on how much and when. I don't know if we're to that point. I wouldn't recommend making that decision at this point myself.
Would it make sense to get the program manager on board, let him and his staff work on cash flow analysis for us, and then we'll know what that amount might be? At that point, we could reconvene, talk about this issue again, and then make a recommendation to the Board of Commissioners.
We've only been working off of one schedule. That schedule of how fast or how slow it takes to build these things can shift dramatically. And there goes millions of dollars in a construction schedule. So
and
that's
help, important. Help this group with this. If in fact we follow that timeline, but we need some funding on the front end to pay for the project manager and maybe even the architect, we've got funding elsewhere that we can use until we cure this funding for the project.
Yes, and we've fronted some money to buy the properties and so on. So.
What kind of time frame would that be? 2-3 months out? So if you're thinking about we revisit this again.
Really, probably when we get the program manager.
That's what I'm saying. What do you anticipate?
The RFP closes on the 24th of May.
Right.
And so after that, it's the selection process. And it really, I hate to put a timeline on the selection process, it really depends on how many we get.
Right.
I have had 36 firms pick up, and I took out the ones that I know aren't firms. 36 firms have picked up the proposal. So I'm not going to get 36 responses, I don't believe.
3-4 months, 2-4 months?
Once we get them, we have our initial kickoff meeting on the 30th of this month, of May. I would say at least a 4-week period before we take it to this board and then to the Board of Commissioners for review.
Okay, so then they have to have time to put their numbers together.
Exactly.
So you could be 4 months out.
Yeah, they'll need some time to get on board and look at the program.
Very good. Just trying to get an idea.
Right.
Sure. Any other discussion on that item? No action on that item at this time. Dave, anything else?
No, we'll keep monitoring market conditions and we'll get the ideas in from the banks as what kind of vehicles they think they could offer.
Thank you. That is the last item on the agenda, unless there's further discussion. One thing I do want to mention is, even though we didn't send out invitations, I think the first time around we had mentioned you are more than welcome to bring your support staff, and that's just an open invitation. If you've got support staff that you would like to have at these meetings, you're welcome to invite them on your own. We don't want to assume that to invite them that you want us to invite them, or we assume who those folks are. So any support staff you'd like to have in these meetings, please invite them.
Commissioners don't get support staff, sir. I think you're talking to me.
I am your support staff.
He's here.
Do I hear any other business before the board? For this team? All right, do I hear a motion to adjourn?
Salute.
Second.
All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We are adjourned. Thank you very much. Yes, don't leave.
Did
you?
Okay.
You should get it.
Okay.
So, you don't let me know, but I already sent it out. You're welcome.
Yeah.